I'm Emily. I am a multimedia journalism major, and I'm originally from Scottsdale, Arizona.
I am also Emily, and I'm an outdoor recreation and leadership management major from Lansing, Michigan.
I am Georgia. I am a biophysiology major from Escanaba, Michigan.
I'm Cody. I'm a human resource management major, and I'm from here.
My name is Paxton. I'm a biochemistry major, and I am also from Escanaba, Michigan.
And my name is Ava Larson. I'm a social media design management major, and I'm also from Marshall. All right, so with a show of hands, how many of you own an Apple product or use one of their services? Yeah, so most hands are raised in the room. However, this wasn't always the case. They didn't always have this many devoted users.
So back when Apple started, they came from very humble beginnings. It was originally created by two college dropouts, both going by the name of Steve. The one you probably know is Steve Jobs, who later carried on the business. In the beginning, they created Apple One, their very first computer, in Steve Jobs' garage. And with that, they wanted to create this computer to have more of a user-friendly operation and features on it. So when they came out with this, they had to advertise it in a way that people would understand and know what these new features were. So, when they created this, they came up with the original marketing plan of Jobs' idea that people don't know what they want in the market. They didn't know what they really wanted from him. So, his idea was to create something that they wouldn't feel that they needed to buy, but something that they would want to spend their money on, something that they would be proud to own and have and show off in a sense. So with that, he created long-lasting customers because they got so used to thinking that this is something that they wanted to consistently spend their money on. But he had to also keep these customers engaged. Hence, you'll see the drop of new ideas and features and technologies throughout the growth of their brand. And then with that, they had to create advertisements to grow with not only them as a brand creating new products, but with their customers as well, and as they gained a higher popularity and became more of a luxury brand. All right, and here's a little timeline of some of the major important moments in Apple's history. Now, this is not all of them because there are a lot of them, but going through quickly, you can see the progression from Apple One, the computer, all the way up to the current AirPods. Doing this every so often allowed Apple to expand and grow and attract people more and more and more to come back while keeping those loyal customers here. So, as you can see, with Jobs and Wozniak creating the first one in 1997. He left the brand around 1980. So he left pretty early on, and from there it was Steve Jobs creating all of these new things until his death, unfortunately, in 2011.
Okay, so for the environmental analysis, although Apple does not make any political contributions, they are known to contribute to certain organizations and initiatives. One of them being helping the public schools in Cupertino, California, which is their hometown. In some states, entities and individuals who are involved in public policy are required to register officially. There are Apple advocates in 44 states and the District of Columbia. Apple has a multifaceted environmental approach with made up of three key components. So these three key components are listed in the image on the screen, and they are resources, climate change, and smarter chemistry. So inflation and costs are steadily increasing for Apple. One of these main rising costs is a decrease in availability of freight due to the COVID-19 pandemic. And then another one is competitive wages among other tech giants such as Amazon and Google. In June of this year, Apple held its Worldwide Developers Conference. In this conference, 13 new technologies were announced. These technologies include updates to their existing technologies such as the Apple TV, Apple Watch, iPad, and iPhone.
Alright, so Apple's current marketing plan. So what are some words that come to mind when you think of Apple's brand image?
Yeah. User-friendly.
Mm-hmm. Any other ones? You can just shove them up to the front to raise your
hand. Simplistic. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so these are some qualities that they're able to carry throughout their entire line of products. All right, so Apple prides itself on having created an entire unique about this ecosystem is the products are able to be connected to one another very easily. So this provides users with a seamless experience transferring from one device to another. So Apple also has a very devoted customer base. According to a report from CIRP, over the last 3 years, they've maintained a brand loyalty rating of over 90%. And in comparison, the second runner-up was Samsung, who held a loyalty rating of 70%. So that 90% is very impressive. They're also able to maintain this base so well because they continually create products with the same core brand image. They're also able to attract new customers due to their sleek and intuitive designs. It makes it easy for new users to pick up their technology and figure it out fairly quickly. Their target market is also the upper and middle class citizens and the younger generation, so millennials, Gen Z. But they're also able to target the older generations because of their intuitive technology. Right, and then marketing performance. So in 2018, Apple became the first $1 trillion company. And then only 2 years later, they hit the $2 trillion mark. So as far as performance goes, they're pretty much top tier. And not only were they able to create a really successful iPhone line, but they also were able to expand into other areas like their AirPods and AirTags, which generate an insane amount of revenue yearly as well. In 2021, it's estimated that they made $12.1 billion just off their AirPod sales alone. So Apple products are made overseas, which in countries such as China and Thailand, and products that are manufactured overseas have a record for not being produced super ethically. They've also been targeted in the past for workers' rights issues. In 2019, they were sued by families whose children died in their cobalt mines. They also have a shaky past when it comes to environmental policy. They have poor environmental reporting, which usually isn't a great thing. They're also not very transparent. However, they do on their website have this page where they do display some things that they are doing for the environment, such as no outer plastic wrap on their packaging.
Now we have the marketing mix. So our products, some of the most commonly used ones would be like iPhone, iPad, iPod Touch, the Apple Watch, HomePod, Beats products. And then some of the intangible products that we're not as familiar with would be Apple Music, Apple Pay, and Apple Software, so like iTunes, or iPhone. So Apple has over 520 stores in 25 different countries. If you want to go. So you can see that right here it kind of shows you, so the dark red is above 200. Pretty much in the United States is the only place where we have more than 200 of Apple stores. And then any of the lighter red, so Australia, China, and Canada, they're anywhere from 21 to 200 stores. And then in this graph right here, you can see the actual number of stores that each of these countries have. And then Apple also offers an online store and an app store. This is all, you can find all this on their website, which is accessible. And then we have promotions. So Apple advertises their products through commercials on TV, so through magazines. I read somewhere that Vogue, actually, they were promoting it on the Vogue magazine. And then we have social media sites, so Facebook and Twitter. Right here you can see Apple has their own Twitter account, and they actually posted this to the page. It's basically just informing like about the new events that are coming. Apple also has yearly keynote speeches. This basically just promotes all their products, tells us about upcoming events or products in the near future. And then we have price. So Apple uses both premium and freemium pricing strategies. So the premium is basically used when companies, so they charge higher prices for their products, and so that like our perception of their products are of higher value. So Apple tries to, I guess, market up their products by having a higher price, because then everybody just thinks that their products are going to be better than its competitors. And then premium pricing is also kind of included in this. So You buy a product or service at no cost, and then afterwards it's gonna be like a feature that you get, but then you have to pay even more for that feature. So like iCloud. So you already get iCloud when you purchase any of the Apple products, but if you want more storage, you have to pay for more storage. And then Apple's creative innovation and efficient sales and marketing teams ensure profitability.
All right, so for their SWOT analysis, it begins with their strengths, which includes customer loyalty thanks to their easy-to-use products, and they're very dependable, and they all connect to each other, everybody loves them. And we go into their weaknesses, which is their overseas manufacturing. If anything were ever to happen, like with shipping, or if they were ever shut down, their sales would plummet due to them not being able to get their products. And then they also started a streaming service known as Apple TV, and they were late to this service, so now they're trying to fight with Netflix and Hulu to become number one for this. And they have a lot of opportunities they could move into, such as artificial intelligence, which you can already see with Siri, or they could move into self-driving technology because they're so big that whatever they get their hands on, they're usually successful in this. And you can see this with the Tile versus the Apple AirTag. They came out with Tile first, which you can hook up to your other technology so you can find it. And Apple came out with an AirTag that people are buying more because the location services are better and people are just loyal to the Apple brand. And then they have threats like Samsung and Google, which are other phone companies, and also Amazon, which you might not think of at first, but Amazon has the opportunity to move into technologies that Apple has, and you can see this with, they have Amazon Prime Video, and they also have Kindles. But it would be really hard for Apple to move into services that Amazon has because it wouldn't be on brand for them to do like delivery services or grocery services.
So for the case study analysis, we chose Samsung as the biggest competitor. So Samsung offers a lot of the same prices, like a lot of the same products that you see on the screen as Apple does, such as the phone, the tablet, the computer. However, they have a wider range of prices, so they're Samsung A12 starts at $249, and that's like the baseline comparable to the new iPhone 12s, which start at $429. So this price range difference allows those customers who might not have that much disposable income to have the amenities that come with a smartphone. Along with this, Samsung is in the appliance sector of the economy, so they have things like refrigerators, dishwashers, and washers and dryers, where Apple doesn't. So these appliances can seamlessly hook to these people's phones, which is not a feature that Apple offers. Samsung also offers split screen on their phones, which allows busy users to multitask, another feature that is not offered on the Apple iPhone. So the Samsung also just came out with a new Flip 4, which is like a flip phone. It's kind of nostalgic because you remember the Motorola flip phones that everybody had. And it's also very compact, which is very attractive to some buyers. However, Samsung's customer service is really poor. I was looking through the reviews, and there's a lot of people who have some Samsung phones that are really not happy with the customer service. They say it's not reliable, it's not up to par with Apple's. Apple's users are extremely satisfied with the customer service. It's easy to use and it's dependable. So on the next slide, there's a little advertisement for the Samsung